What we want to see and what we're looking to see is, what is the cognitive impact of CrossFit on people? Does it help them focus better? Does it help them think more clearly? Does it actually improve the function of their brain? And what better people to work with than teachers?
It really begs the question, what would happen if we take these 18 teachers, administrators, and put them into a box and let them experience it?
I really want to expose them to as many different workouts as I can. I want them to think about, what can I do with my class?
Can we turn on that light, like, yeah, that might be important to teach our students?
Oh, absolutely. I think it should be, you know, a beacon of light.
You can't force this team building or these bonding exercises, but you put them through CrossFit and it's amazing how close these people are going to get to each other.
Teachers need to take control of their health and fitness so they can be better role models for their students. This is our audience. This is who we're in front of for 8 hours a day.
They're going to see their lives changed.
This is the final workout of from October, November,
all the way through
March. The last day we finally get a nice warm weather for us to run. So one more workout.
One more workout.
And then we set them free.
Yes.
No, don't do it. Yeah. Don't.
No win.
I think these six or seven people have came in here every chance they get.
Make it count!
We have to do this 3 times.
Where was this run when you guys were doing your...
They took it serious, and I think the more results they saw, the more serious they took it.
Before, they took it easy. Now they made me run.
Sandbagging.
I'm sweaty.
Sandbagging.
It was Angela's first big lap for the warm-up without stopping. First one. Today. Boom.
Who are you? My name is Angela Pennington, and I am the logistics manager and executive assistant to the head of Cannon School. I've been doing CrossFit since October. I wasn't going to do it. It was my coworkers that actually convinced me to do it, because I have had quite a few surgeries on my legs and thought, you know, I could never do something like CrossFit. I've overcome a greater part of fear. When you spend so much money, when you go through physical therapy, when you just go through the surgeries, there's a certain fear that you live with of what you can't do, because it's very real. You don't want to hurt yourself. When I tell people that have known me through all of my surgeries, through all the 12 weeks non-weight bearing, through the metal, the screws, the removal, when I tell them that I am doing CrossFit, they are just like amazed and they're very proud of me.
Got it.
Yes.
I don't even know. It's on a daily basis. If I need to move something, it's just a general feeling of, I don't worry as much about my physical condition. I don't worry as much about the numb. I don't walk with that thought of how many surgeries I've had or what the physical therapies were or what the warnings are. You know, I mean, I'm using common sense, but I am able to approach things like, you know, oh, I can try to lift that.
You're walking taller.
I am. Yeah, and people around me, you know, they're like, oh, wow, you just lifted that. And I'm like, yeah, because I can deadlift. You know, yeah, because now I'm obnoxious about it. Now it's kind of a joke at work. When they see me put the gloves on, they know I'm shutting it down. And I'm going to go CrossFit. Yeah.
So this isn't a workout?
Technicalities.
It's a skill session. Okay. This is just to get them a little bit better at running and see how they control their heart rate. The real fun will start before the actual workout.
I've been doing CrossFit for 4 months. I've lost about 10 pounds, and I did the paleo challenge and I lost about 10 and a half inches.
And are you proud of yourself?
I am very proud of myself. I just joined CrossFit Vitality, so I'm
going
to keep it up.
What?
Yeah.
You're official?
Yes, I'm official.
Was it difficult to come to that decision?
No, not at all. I've seen very good results. I can do things that I never thought I would be able to do, and I want to continue with that. I never thought I could do a push-up. I can do like 15 push-ups in a row. I ran 3 miles without stopping the other day. That's really big for me.
True confessions.
I did the paleo challenge for 6 weeks and I kept doing it, and I went out of town this weekend and I ate some food I haven't been eating and I just don't feel good. I just want to go to sleep.
I can't just say this is paleo and I'm going to do paleo. However, I will say that since I started this program, I eat differently because it impacts my workout. And I think that that is more significant and that is more lasting. So I'm not on a paleo thing and then I kind of look and say, oh, I'm going to splurge and eat a piece of bread. Things I don't eat anymore because they impact my workout negatively. And I want to have a good workout. So that's why I have changed some things about what I eat.
I can tell you are looking awesome.
I feel awesome. Thank you, Gary.
We'll see you tomorrow.
Now, there will be no paleo tomorrow during our party.
My first goal starting was just to show up because that was a big deal. Like leaving my desk, unfinished business to get here and do this for me. And I did it.
She has been diehard in the group the whole time. She comes from a running background before doing CrossFit, so this has given her a brand new sense of what it means to be fit.
I can do push-ups now. I couldn't do push-ups before.
Let me see push-ups.
Like a real push-up too. So that was the most unbroken I've done so far. When I couldn't do any when we started.
You can't quite do the whole push-up, just do the...
If you can't do the whole push-up, we'll do 7 negatives on that push-up.
And now I feel like I can do real ones, strong girl ones.
She almost won the paleo challenge for us. She came in 2nd place in the paleo challenge. She killed it. She lost, gosh, I don't know how many inches. And a high percentage of her body weight too, so it was good.
Are there any measurable, observable, repeatable things in your life that as a teacher you know has improved?
When you feel better inside, there's no way that it can affect you in your job. And this is my job, this is my career, this is my lifelong passion, this is what I do, and it would be a lie to say that it has not affected me in the classroom. I've got more energy. My students, I think, have noticed. I don't think they really know kind of what's going on, but I do feel better, more energetic, and I think it comes out in my lessons. I know it comes out in my lessons when I'm with them. Definitely more, you know, pumped up.
It's good to see someone that was brand new do that paleo challenge. You knew that she didn't really believe that she was gonna get any results. And every week, you could just see it, like, she started to believe more and more. And then by week 4, she's like, I can't believe how different I feel.
So my goals right now, I wanna continue coming. I wanna continue CrossFitting, get more experience. Eventually, I really want my level 1 certification, which would eventually lead to CrossFit Kids, because that's really what I wanna do. Of course, developing their fitness, but there's so much more to CrossFit than just fitness. It's emotional, it's mental, physical, it's all of that all tied together.
The 14.2, we're gonna watch what the announcement is, but everybody has done the movements, so you all know what everything is. So everybody will be participating. What'd you say?
The following is a presentation of CrossFit HQ.
Nobody at this time, Thursday night, 8 o'clock, nobody in the world knew what it was. Nobody knows the workout. So they announce it.
And then the people that are there have to do it.
Yes.
Oh my gosh.
Well, yeah.
In 3 minutes, attempt to complete 2 rounds of 10 overhead squats, 10 chest to bar pull-ups.
He's not done explaining it.
So, the 2 rounds stay fixed throughout. The first round is 2 rounds of 10 overhead squats, 10 chest to bar pull-ups. The second round, the reps increase to 12 and 12.
There we go. How many schools around the country are showing open announcements in class?
I would bet I am one of the only schools.
Well,
We don't have to hand in traditional lesson plans like other schools, another school I've taught. They pretty much, since we're on this honor code, just trust us that we have developed a good curriculum and let us do our thing.
Do you decide who?
Yes.
I was just asking about that.
My future is in her hands right now.
Really? That's the advantage of being an independent school, where teachers can dream and they're allowed and given the margin to teach classes that fall within their personal passions. So that's why Meredith's allowed to do something like that here.
Because I just told her I added up all the meters that I ran yesterday, and it's been like, it was like a mile and a half, which I never, that never was going to happen. That was never in my life plan that that would ever happen.
What's happening over here? What's going on?
I'm just so happy for her.